Hi, this is Darman. Welcome to another Minecraft Let's Play video. In this video series, I'm showing you how to build Stampy's lovely world. And here we are strolling along the path here in Stampy's town. You can see the music tower in the background and all kinds of stuff around us. So in the last video, we finished up the Googly's Manor, and the tank came out great, I think. So today we are going to start on the restaurants. We're kind of behind on this sort of area over here, and it's my fault. Sorry about that. But the sushi restaurant is the one we're building today. Obviously, you saw the title of the video, and obviously it goes right here. So the way we left this area so far is yours. If you followed all my videos, probably looks like this. It's just kind of got a flat wall, and there's some sand and some stuff over here. And part of what we're going to do for this build, not in today's video, is we're going to do a little bit of terrain. We're going to do just enough terrain to squeak by to the end of the restaurant. So and that's what we're going to do for the restaurants on this side is rather than doing like all the terrain all the way down, which can, let's be honest, it can be kind of boring. We'll just integrate a little bit of terrain as needed into each one, just so that we'll get it all done and it won't be too horrible to get through. And we will have to change some of this as well that we've already got here. There's absolutely no sand over here anymore. The basic shape really hasn't changed all that much, and probably really isn't all that terribly important anyway. But and this is all still one block deep here for me, and I'm not sure, your world may have it deeper or whatnot, but one is always easy. One, especially towards it, as you get towards the land here, it's always easier to have just the one block deep, so you can easily outline, you can easily just put blocks down to outline your terrain that you're going to put down and so forth. So anyway, so I'm going to keep that just like it is. And so we're going to start this like we always do. We're going to start with the path, and the path that is the path leading up to the building, in this case a restaurant. And just real quick, I wanted to just make sure everybody's on the same page here. We did some time ago in an update video alter this path from the way it originally was. It used to be one block closer to the post office here. Now it is two blocks away, so it just moved this way one block. So just know that. And of course over here, this path here was originally one block over here. It used to rub right up against this building, and now it's one block away from it. It had been moved at some point. So just keep that in mind because we're going to start over here, which means if you haven't already moved to this path, then you have to do that first before we go ahead and start building the restaurant here. You're just going to be a block off, and not that that's a big deal, but it'll just throw off my instructions for you just a little bit. So let's get started. We're going to begin by finding the beginning of the path here. Right here, we're going to go to this this grass here. We're going to go to the 10th block from here. And let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And I'm guessing there's probably, this is all empty under here, and there's some torches. I got rid of some of the water that would just interfere with the build later. Yours may or may not look like that. If you're built on if you got Stampy Seed, then, if you've got Stampy Seed, you probably have a big hollow spot under there for the most part, as well, because you probably just did the same thing I did, just to build one layer just kind of straight out. But if you have to dig, you are going to have to dig, and I'm going to explain more about that later as part of your homework. So we got to the 10th block over here, and this path is going to be 5 blocks wide, 2, 3, 4, 5, and it's going to be 9 blocks deep, 9 blocks long, in other words. So it's got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and I'm just going to connect this up here and dig this out. Now, because it's hollow under here, we're going to have to add just a little bit of something underneath, because on the edges there's going to be logs. So I'm going to pick my favorite material, which is diamonds, just so that I know it's not part of the build. It is just something that I've added on in order to get something done. So I'm just going to put this here on each of the edges, because that is where the logs go, and you just can't get logs to face the right way anymore unless you're facing a certain direction. So with that, we're just going to take these are jungle logs. This is all mostly made out of jungle, and there's some birch and some jungle planks and so forth, and a little bit of spruce for the seating. But anyway, so that's how we're going to start here. This is five blocks wide total, so now we've got three left in here that we have to do, and since we're just using regular blocks at this point, we don't need to put anything underneath there, and we'll just get rid of that diamond later, or we won't, who cares, no one will ever see it. So on the outside it's going to be some jungle wood, so grab your jungle wood, which is just kind of has a little bit of a red tint, and just make a ring all the way around here, and then in the middle we're just going to put some birch stripe right down the middle. Now this has fences, but I'm sure you know by now, the fences are not, they alternate between jungle and birch, so they start out with jungle, and so you're just going to go every other one here, and then fill it in with birch, same thing on this side, and we're going to build. Should we build the archway? I'm messing this all up. Why not? We'll build the archway at least so you can see how it's done. Because the same exact archway is going to appear on the deck that goes out over the water. So today, what we're going to try to do is get the overall building done and get it set up underneath so that we can build the kind of the guts of it. And then we'll do like the top side, kind of much in the way that Stampy did in his videos. Except he built this part and the little ponds next to it. He built that off camera, which, that's always fun to try to figure out. Thank you. But that's okay. We got it all straightened out. With some help from people, we got it straightened out. So there's a little archway here. And again, it's just alternating materials. We've got jungle and then birch. So we're going to go up a total of four on each side. So we just have to alternate as we do it. So it's four on that side, and let's see, put birch, then jungle, then birch. Okay, so that's four, and then we go in, we're going to still alternate, so that's birch, so we're going to go in with jungle. I'm going to say the wrong thing, I just know it. And then we're going to go up one on each side, so these are both going to be birch, and then there's going to be one in the middle, which is going to be jungle. And since we have a torch here, there's going to be a torch right on top. And why not? We'll put the one over here. There's one like right in the middle. It's like the fifth one from the front. One, two, three, four. Yeah, right here. On top of these middle jungle ones. All right. So, okay. So this is our entrance. So what we're going to do is grab our birch. And it's not quite square, the building, but it's... The corners are kind of chopped off a little bit, so I'm sure you've seen that. So it is 15, the part we're going to build right now is 15 blocks wide. So if this is the middle, that means we have to have 14 on each side, because there's a doorway right in the middle here. So let's see, 14 on each side, so it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, no. It's 15 blocks long total, so that's the middle, so there's 7 on each one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6, 7. Sorry, it's been a long time since I've been in school. You know, what can I say? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So that'll be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Okay, so that's 15 blocks long there. And then we're going to put a row of jungle planks on top of that and leave a little space for the door. And one more row of birch on top of that, although we can go right over top of that doorway. There we go. Then we're going to take jungle plank and we're going to put it, how do we do this? All right, you know what? Let's do the corner first. Right here, not here on the corner, but kind of in diagonally, we're going to bring it in. Might as well bring it all the way up to the fourth level, because that's what you're going to need on each end. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, 4 is sticking up. And we need to run the log, but not this way. We need to kind of run it sideways, but I can't put it sideways until I have at least something to make it go sideways like that. So we're going to put that one down there, make this sideways all the way over to here, and then I'll just have to go back on this end and fix this end. I can't think of an easier way to do that. There we go. All right, and that's what we're going to do on all sides. What we should do also is right here, we're going to substitute now. This is going to be logs here. And here, and then I'll have to do this one from underneath like that. As I place that block, I'm wondering, I'm not sure if I ever verified if does it go like that or does it go like this. No, I don't think so, but at least then that would that way you wouldn't see the end of it kind of sticking out there. So I'm just going to leave it like this for now. But, oops, now I can't even get to do it right. There we go. No, there, like that. That way this matches up, this pattern. Yeah, we'll go with that for now. I'm sure somebody will set me straight if that is wrong. I appreciate those sort of things. So now we've got this like that, and we want to do the exact same thing on these other sides. So in this case, we're going to bring out here. We're going to go 15 blocks, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So you should, if you build it the way I did, you should have three more grass blocks here. And this is going to line up with the second block right here on this corner like that. Don't worry, this, like I said, this terrain's going to change a little bit, but we need, we are going to end up carving out actually this later at a later date. So then, you know, the corner goes here, and then, you know, the other one here on this side. And I didn't count, so I'm just going to quickly go over here and just make this meet up here, and then we'll figure out where the two meet together. We should, oh, look at that. That worked out perfectly. I'm awesome today. Okay, so that's going to be the overall outline. So let's just have my helper come in and fill the other walls exactly like the one we just did. Of course, there's not going to be a, you know, no doorway on the other walls, but do bring down three vertical rows of the jungle on each side, including the back one. Yeah, I just wanted to check my notes there for a second. Okay, so let's have him do that. There we go. And like I said, in the middle of each side, we get to, where's the middle? It looks like it's here, the middle three on each side. Here we go. All right, so I'll just get rid of these. This actually, on this side, where this is like where the hole is, that goes, you know, where the fish go down. And did that go sideways? Okay, no, that's okay. All right, so there's a little extra that goes down just so that, you know, makes it look nice. There's a chicken going off in my ear. Okay, it looks like the middle there. We'll find out at some point if that's not the middle for sure. And let's put this here and there. And then just one side over here. Is this the middle here? Let's take a gander that way. Yep, that looks good. I think I did okay. I think that's something I'm okay at. It's fine in the middle of stuff. I don't know. Stampy said that recently. I shouldn't. Sounds like I'm copying. I'm sorry. Okay, so there's our basic building. Let's build the roof, because that's cool. Here, I already got my diamond ready to go. So we're going to have to build these blocks kind of float out in the air. So what we're going to do first is use our jungle planks. We're going to use, actually, he used dirt, but I'm using diamond. We have to kind of build up diagonally. It's not real easy to do, just because we have to make these logs facing the right way, in the same way. So we're going to go up five from here. So this is the first one. And so we have to go up a little bit more for the next one. Get that there. So we're just going to keep repeating that until I know I'm not doing my most efficient edit. Nope, not like that. Like that. What did I mess up here? Going around in my little inventory here, because I go around the wrong way. So that's three. Let's go back this way. I'm going to do this. Good enough. Four. And oops. No, that's not a good spot for it. And the last one, five. So we want to have five going up diagonally from here. So now I can get rid of my excess ones here. You can use whatever material you want. Just use something that you won't get confused that you do or do not have to remember to get rid of it. So there, it's just sort of floating up like that. We're going to do the same thing on the other four corners. I'm going to let my helper add those in, since you already know how to do that. Now we just need to connect these up on top, just the top one, with some sideways ones, so we don't have to put anything underneath, thank goodness. So we can just draw these out like this. So now we just need to put some jungle leaves all over these parts of the roof, and then the roof will basically be done. Let's see, jungle. So basically, all you have to do is, wherever there's a block, you're just gonna, you can put one in front of it, and just go all the way around. Same here. Go to the next one, put a block in front of that one, and so forth. It's easy peasy. Couldn't be any simpler. Just don't put any on top of these corner pieces. They're supposed to be left exposed Just like that. Nope, not like that. Like that. I'm going to go all the way around. There's a couple of torches up here. Not too much. I guess I can just kind of face this direction to do this one. Oh, that's nice and easy. Torches, they go up here on the corners. The four corners up here. Since we're here, we might as well put them up here. Sometimes I do torches kind of at the end, but that's all right. We'll just do that there. And there's also ones at the very bottom corners here, like that. All the way around, and we actually have to cap off the ends of these logs down here. These ends here, we have to put a what do you call it? Hatch? I don't know what these things are called. What trap door? Wooden trap door. Okay, here we go. Yeah, these go. Whoops, I'm getting rid of my stuff here. Yeah, so at the end of all these, there should be a little trap door. It just kind of covers up the end, I guess, and looks decorative. Kind of makes it a little detail interest, I guess you could say. So go ahead and finish off putting these on all the ends, finish off the roof, and let's see, how many more of these I have to do? I got one here, and did I do this one yet? Yep, I did that one. Okay. Alright, so I'm just going to have my helper finish off the roof. Oh, and in the middle here, this is just, you know, more jungle. I'll just fill this in up here. So go ahead and yeah, let's put this in here, and then I'll let my helper come in and finish off the roof. There we go. Okay, so then the rest of the roof will look like this. And now we can move on to, you know what, since we have torches and we already put down a few of them, there are torches on each side. They're exactly the same. We're going to go from each end to the fourth block, 1, 2, 3, 4, then put one in the middle, which I think leaves four more, 1, 2, I guess it's only three in between there. 1, 2, 3 here, and so there's three here, and then there's three in between each one, like that. So that's nice and symmetrical. So we can have, let's see, 1, 2, 3 done, 1, 2, 3 middle, 1, 2, 3 that one, and we're just gonna repeat this. 1, 2, 3 boop, 1, 2, 3 You don't have to do the boop. You can make your own sound. 1, 2, 3 kapow. 1, 2, 3 All right, one more. 1, 2, 3 ka-ching. 1, 2, 3 whoop, whoop. 1, 2, 3 gazooga. There we go. Okay, so now we've got, I think we got basically, that's almost all the torches on the outside for the part that we've built here. So we've got this nice start here. Let's see. So let's, I'm going to take out the floor, but we're going to talk about it in just a second. I'm going to have you dig down. You should be digging down five blocks just to make this easy. So, you know, this being the first one and then four more. Yeah, I know. I've already showed you. I've got stuff. It's already done for me, basically. It's because the way we already built this. So that worked out well. So you may need to dig out a bit more than I do. But here's what mine looks like. So, yeah, this is me here. This is what I've got. And wow, I actually lined up. I went down there and under here, and I just randomly put this, you know, grass here, and then just drained the water from out of here using some sponges. And I did not realize that it perfectly lined up with that, so that would work out perfectly. But that doesn't even really matter. It doesn't need to be quite this big because the most of the works that are important are kind of like in the middle where the, you know, piston are and the timing mechanism and the water that comes this way over here and back over this way don't really matter that you've blocked it out, but obviously feel free to knock out as much as you want. Just make sure you leave something underneath these corners. And there's been some debate about whether this had been changed into some other material besides dirt, and I do not know, I must say. He never kind of, he gets covered up. You're not really going to see it. Why is that growing grass? I don't know. You're not going to see it, and it'll blend right in, so I'm going to leave it. I'm going to leave the dirt, and if we find out it's changed, we can always go back and do it if we really want to get kind of crazy with that. And I will say right here, while I'm here, this is jungle, and this should be facing this way. That's how he has it there. And over here, there's two doorways, and those are actually going to have birch in the fact, we should make them now. Let's punch them out. They just go right in the middle of each side here, and then there's going to be birch planks underneath those. Let's do that. And so now we've got, Now we've got this. This is what we're left with over here. So we've got one. I'm looking at it. Kind of looks like a little face with the hair. You know, like if you put a little nose, like here, and then maybe like a little mouth, maybe a little smiley face. Here we go. Look at him. Look at that happy guy. He's all okay. All right. I need rest. I need sleep or something. That's funny. That's right. I'll leave that. That's kind of like an indented nose. You can put whatever you want there, but we will come back and do the actual terrain. This is going to get punched out anyway, so I'm not too worried about leaving that way. We might as well put them on here before I forget. The jungle doors, which kind of doing this in a weird order. Oh, here they are in a weird order. But that way we can put that there from the outside. Put the doors down the same as on the front. Ooh, flying around a little too fast. Sorry. There we go. Okay, so we'll put a sign and so forth there. So right now what we've got is a pretty good building. So let's do. Oh, I got rid of it already. I'm gonna grab the jungle wood logs again, and we're gonna do the inside, and we're gonna have to put the logs, you know, facing this way. So I'm gonna need to grab some dirt, and I'm just gonna. They need to put dirt like kind of under here, the way we did, kind of like we did for that, you know, to build this, except this is going to go straight out here. I need to go down farther, don't I? I need to go down one more. Oh, so confused. Okay. Yeah. Because the logs are going to go here, and then the grasses or the, leaves are going to go on top of that. So we need to put it that level. So let's just replace that with some. If the logs have to go here, then under here. Oh, of course, there's a torch there in my way. So I'm just going to go out diagonally this direction. I think I only need to go three, but a little overkill here. So let's see. So it's one. Oops. 1, 2, 3. We can get rid of the rest of that. And then once you do that on each corner of the room. This place is really nicely symmetrical, so let's see, that'll be leaves. This will be where the logs attach, so I have to go under here to put it here like that. So 1, 2, 3, then I'll just put the logs down on top of these. Oops, not there, diagonal, there we go. Okay, so we've got two like that, and then all you have to do is just connect them with sideways logs, which is nice because you don't have to put anything underneath of them, and put them like that. And so each section, each side is going to be like this, where they're going to go sideways into this, and these little kind of corner ones just sort of act like as a little visual connector that way, because otherwise when you put like two together, they kind of have this weird little transition there. So he gets around that by putting these pieces in like that. So each side will be like that, these are going to go out this way and so forth. You know, each side is going to go, you know, parallel to the wall next to it, of course. So go ahead and let's do the rest of that, just the outline, just three. This is just this should be three. This should only be three blocks away from the wall. It doesn't really matter if you go four, you're not going to see it. Yeah, but he didn't do it that way, so we're not going to do it that way. It shouldn't matter, but there's probably something I'm not thinking of that probably will make a difference at some point in the build. So let's see. Yeah, we can do that. All right, yeah, so three blocks, three rows out on each side is going to do the trick. So let's add that. And with that, we just need to we're going to put some glowstone. Let's see, where is the glowstone these days? Oh, there it is. I saw that Minecraft has added, or Microsoft, whoever, has added basically a spontaneous spleef, a spleef game, which is cool. I haven't played yet, but yeah, I did see that. All right, so there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 glowstones on each side. Where's my glowstone? There. Basically, you're going to start right here. If you start with this one block here, and you know, as if that one was glowstone, and just go every other 1, 2, 3, 4, five, six. That gives you six on each side. So you're going to do that on each side. That helps light things up quite a bit on the inside. That way you don't have to worry about torches and so forth. It's always good. So now what we want to do after we do this, well, we might as well put the jungle leaves on because it's not going to hinder us from doing anything else. There we go. So the jungle leaves just go straight on top of this, and again, you're not going to really see that dirt and so forth there. It does call into question whether or not I would not be at all surprised if there actually was some, you know, he brought the, I don't know, maybe the alternated again with the what do you call it, the jungle wood mirror, the planks, maybe, I don't know. So if I ever find out, I will let you know. Otherwise, we are just going to go along here, put this on here. That way we have this is the official floor of the restaurant. And what a fascinating concept for the restaurant. I mean, using the new introduction of the slime, now the slimes are bouncy slime blocks, and being able to launch things using your pistons. Thank you, brain. So now we don't want to build anything else up here until we build the stuff down below, because it's really the only thing we really want to probably do is find the middle, because that is where our mechanisms are going to go. So we'll mark that with how about some diamond. We'll do that. Let's see, so it looks like it should be right about here, and actually looks like more like here. Let's go here. If we go up this wall, it should be in the middle of that one. That's good. We go in over here, up the middle. Okay, good, right there. So find the middle, however you want to do it, the middle of this square here, and this is a square here. And so let's just mark that. Just keep that in mind. So we'll do this in the next video, just because we have to kind of dig through here, and I want to have the deck sort of built, which means in the next video what we're going to do is we're going to do the little bit of terrain that we need to do out there. We'll build the deck. And we'll try to get this part down here done. We'll see how that goes. I'll tell you what, we're going to extend this video just a little bit. I don't want to do any of that quite yet, because that would involve the terrain. But we will. Let's do the fountains real quick. How quick? I don't know. I think we can do these pretty quick. Now, unfortunately, it's empty under here. So. I'm gonna have to get creative on how to keep the water in there. We'll have to put a bottom on there somehow. So from here, let's see, on the this is the right side of it. Let's dig out the overall shape of this one. Now it's one block away, so this row of grass will have no changes on it. But if we go into this one, we're going to go to the fourth block, 1, 2, 3. We're going to knock out this one and the two here. Oh, look, I've actually got one. I guess that's the wall over here from a previous wall from sometime in the past. So we've got these three. No, actually, it should be two. Should be these, just these two. So, yeah, 1, 2, 3, and then knock out those two. And then we're going to knock out this one diagonally here. And again, diagonally here, and then go one more back like that, and then back into the left diagonally there, and block out, and then diagonally again here, and then add two to the left of that, so you should have two there. And we're going to pull back one, then go left diagonally back one, and back one more there, go to the right diagonally, and then that should do it. Then we're just going to dig out the rest of this up here carefully. Okay, well, I lucked out that there's this little bit here, so I'm just going to use that to my advantage and just kind of put a floor in like this, and because we're going to have to dig out a little tiny bit more on the underside, down inside each of these. And I don't like this is not grown grass yet, so I'm just going to go ahead and replace that because I get so impatient. And that is not grass. There we go. All right, so that is the overall shape. Let me just double check it. Yeah, it looks pretty good there. Okay, so then down in the second level, and this is where it gets tricky because it's hard to see, but I've looked at as much as I can and gotten help from friends, and I think it looks like this. How about that? So we're going to go like right in the middle of these three here. We're going to pull back one. We're going to knock this one out, and then we're going to knock two in front of that. And then we're going to go back to that block, and we're going to not knock out the one to the right of it. We're going to skip one, do that, knock out these two, knock out these two. So it kind of makes a little sort of like an L there, and then one more right in the middle there. And we'll just go ahead and put that in there. And then we have one piece of glowstone to put in at the bottom of each pond as well. And in this one, let's see, we're facing the restaurant. Oh, I got rid of my glowstone. Oh, that fast. You must have seen that coming, right? Okay, glowstone on this one goes right here. Okay, so right in that first row that's a full three wide, they just put that one right in there. So then we're just gonna let that, you know, we're gonna let that grass grow in there because I think it's probably all grass underneath. Then we'll just put some water in there. So let's grab some vegetation. There's only a couple different types here. We need the blue orchid, and we need the sugar cane, which I think is actually somewhere else. This has got to be tedious to watch me do this. Where is the sugar cane? You know where it is, I bet. Oh, here it is. Okay, here we go. The sugar cane right there. Oh, and we're going to need some string, which was a pretty interesting, neat little trick. So that we're going to put a little piece of string on the top of each of the sugar canes so that they stay the height that we're gonna install them on. So sugar cane right back here. This is gonna be four blocks high. Oh, well, I guess I have to put the water in, don't I? Because you can't put down sugar cane without some water there. We'll put that there. All right, so let's just put some water in here. Let that fill in. Make sure it's nice and, you know, no streams, and then go ahead and, you know, fill in the rest. Just put it around the edges and it should fill in nicely, nice and flat like that. Okay, good. All right. So back here, back this one here on the left of these three here, this one is four blocks high. This one is two, and then this one is three. One, two, three, and then immediately cap them off. And by that, I mean, all you have to do is point at the top block and put the string down, and you can't even, I'm sure you can't see it in the video. It's a tiny, like, gray line inside this box, which represents the string. Very interesting, but it will keep it from growing. You can't really put that on top of anything else. Oh, I guess you can, but it doesn't. It's weird. Like, it makes this like half slab essentially there. So if you were to put something on top of it, I think it actually, I guess it kind of takes up a full block anyway. So it's basically invisible for the all intents and purposes. So let's see, we've got them all on there. Okay, good. All right, so then here in this corner, there's a flower. And then here, this one is this is cane. That's four blocks too high, two, three, four, and some string. This one, there's one right here that's five blocks high, two, three, four, five. Tie that off with some string. And there's a blue flower here in front of that one. Then there's a one block high there, and I get that one. Okay. Then a flower here. Oops. Where do you go? Blue flower here, here, and here. I love these blue flowers and a lot of the new flowers. Nice. Really, you know, very, very cool. I just, lots more color. And see, we need a sugar cane that's two blocks high, and then four, two, three, four. And let's not forget to cap them off. Did that one make it up there? Okay. Yeah. And let's see, okay, so more blue flowers here and here, and then sugarcane three high, whoop, and one more blue flower. I think that's it. Yep, there we go. So that's it. That one's done. Okay, all right, so let's do the next one, and we're going to call this video after we do this, and we'll come back, and don't forget to do your homework. All right, so I'll remind you that in a minute. All right, so then we need to build. Let's see, how are we going to do this one? All right, again, this first row is not touched. Just leave that alone. Go to the second row and go to the left to the third one. One, two, three. We're going to knock that out. The one next to the left of that. We're going to go diagonal here and then to the left of that. Diagonal to this. Diagonal back to the right there. one more time and go back one. So we should be two blocks away from the building at this point. And go two to the right, pull back diagonal. We're one block away from there. And then this row should be four blocks long, two, three, four, and there we go. So now we'll just get rid of this, and I don't have anything really nice to kind of build upon, so we'll just put that there, and that will allow me to build the underside. Or if you can just dig, if you have solid ground on here, then by golly, you're in good shape, because then you can just dig it out, and then you're done, and you're waiting around like, come on, Darman, hurry up, we got to get this done here, and I got to add more underneath. Okay, so that's the first basic shape like that. And this used to be a little bit different over here when he originally built this. But then when he built the hot potato thing, he ended up accidentally destroying part of it in the process of putting in the redstone. And so this is how it ended up looking. It's just, I think it was just like a couple of blocks over here that ended up changing. Anyway, that's a little bit of history there. That's why I tend to not build things right away. I like to build the things that are around it. And sometimes stuff changes. You know, you can't just build stuff right away. So anyway, let's build the level down from this one. Okay, so this goes, let's see, let's start in this corner and go to the third block towards me. One, two, three. And then do the two blocks to the left. And then come back and then do those two blocks. And near as I can tell, that's it. I haven't found any evidence otherwise. I've even been to his world when it's there, and I just, at the time, it was brand new building, and I just didn't know where, you know, sometimes you just don't know, like, what the real questions that you're going to have are in the future, so I didn't have that. So that's where the glowstone, right in the middle of that row. So let's put the water in, and then we can do our vegetation around it, and that'll be it. Let's put some water all over. One there, and okay, good, no streams. Okay, remember when I think originally you couldn't put sugarcane on grass? I don't know, maybe it always had to be on sand. I don't know, I always has, that always has to be next to water. Okay, so this back row, we're going to start with flowers and put the two blue ones here. We're going to build three high on the sugarcane here, tie that off. Four high here, two, three, four, tie that off. Let's see, two more blue flowers here and here, and then sugar cane, that's two blocks high here. Another blue flower there. Here's going to be three block high sugar cane, tie it off. And the front are two blue flowers again. And in here is a four block high tower, two, three, four string, and flower here, and one block high here. Yep, the string on top of that, and blue flower there, and two block high cane there. Oops. And see, over here is another blue flower on this corner, and then finally over here, five block high. Two, three, four, five. That was a tall one. There we go. All right. Wait, did I make it on there? Okay, all right. Perfect. All right, so that is our garden. The front, the entranceway. We still need the sign on the front. I realize that. We'll do that at the end. I like to kind of usually do that at the end. So now, yes, we will, in the next video, we will do the terrain here. We'll do the deck, which, by the way, has furniture on it now. If you picked up on that, some of you I know have. Who've alerted me, we'll do as much as we can of the inside. So definitely one more video, obviously. Hopefully, and no more than two more. Obviously, that there's no possible way you can need to do two more. All right, so I'm just gonna stand right up here and say I'm Darman68. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.